Do I know you?
No, sir.
What's your name?
Teplo.
Teplo.
No, I don't.
You are not a scientist, I think.
Scientist here means a student who has chosen science. No, sir. I'm still in the lower fifth. I can't go to next term. Because I haven't got the remove yet.
Remove here means result. Don't you know if you've got your remove?
No, sir. Mr. Crocker Harris doesn't tell us the results, like other masters.
Why not?
Well, you know what he is like, sir.
But I think there's a rule that results should only be announced by the headmaster on the last day.
Yes, but nobody pays attention to it. Except Mr. Crocker Harris.
I agree. I also don't pay attention to it. So you've to wait until tomorrow morning to know your fate?
Yes, sir.
What, then?
Oh, science, sir. Of course.
Yes. We get all the slackers. Slackers, lazy students.
I'm extremely interested in science, sir.
Are you? I am not. In the science, I have to teach.
Well, anyway, sir, it's more exciting than this muck.
Indicates his book. What is this muck?
Aeschylus, sir. Agamemnon.
The Agamemnon is a Greek play written by Aeschylus. And your considered view is that the Agamemnon is a muck?
Well, no, sir. I don't think the play is muck, exactly. I think it's a good plot, a wife murdering her husband, and all that. I only meant the way it is taught to us, just a lot of Greek words strung together. Greek is not our mother tongue. So, we end up disliking the book.
Are you staying here as a punishment?
No, sir. Extra work.
Extra work? On the last day of school?
Yes, sir. Or I would be playing golf. You would think he is enough busy today, because he is leaving tomorrow. But I missed a day school when I was ill last week, so here I am. Look at the weather, sir. I wanted to play golf in such a good weather.
Bad luck. But still, there is one comfort. Now, you are certain to get your remove tomorrow for being a good boy in taking extra work.
I'm not sure, sir. This would be true for ordinary teachers. They would just give a remove to their students after they're taking extra work. But these type of rules don't apply to the Croc. Mr. Crocker Harris, I asked him yesterday if he would give remove. And do you know what he said, sir?
No. What?
My dear Teplo, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No less. And certainly, no more. Do you know, sir, I think he may have marked me down, rather than up, for taking extra work. I mean, he is hardly human. Sorry, sir. Have I gone too far?
Yes. Much too far.
Sorry, sir. I got carried away.
Teplo.
Yes, sir.
What was that Crocker Harris sent to you? Just repeat it, would you?
My dear Teplo, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No less, and certainly, no more.
Your mimicry is not matching with Crocker Harris. Read your nice Aeschylus, and be quiet.
Aeschylus.
Look, what time did Mr. Crocker Harris tell you to be here?
6:30, sir.
Well, he is 10 minutes late. Why don't you go out? You could still play golf.
Oh, no. I can't go. God knows what will happen if I did. He would probably follow me home or something.
I must admit, I am jealous of Crocker Harris because of the effect he has on you boys. You all seem scared to death of him. What does he do? Beat you all?
Oh, no. He is not a sadist like some other masters.
Sadist?
A sadist, sir, is someone who gets pleasure out of giving pain.
Really? But I think you were saying that some other masters are sadists?
Well, of course, they are, sir. I will not mention their names. But you know which masters are sadists, as well as I do. Most masters think we boys don't understand a thing, but sir, you are different. You are young, well, and science teacher. You must know what sadism is.
Oh God. What are our schools coming to?
Anyway, sir, the croc isn't a sadist. That's what I am saying. He doesn't beat us. And if he would, it would show that he had some feelings. But he hasn't. He hates being liked by people. It's funny. I don't know any other master who doesn't want that people like him.
And I don't know any student who doesn't use this quality of Mr. Crocker Harris for his own purposes.
Well, everybody would do it if it was another master. But not with the croc.
Mr. Crocker Harris.
Mr. Crocker Harris. The funny thing is that, in spite of everything, I like him.
I'm sure you're exaggerating.
No, sir. I'm not. One day in form, he made one of his classical jokes. Of course nobody laughed, because nobody understood it, including me. But I knew he had meant it funny. So, I laughed. Now I can't remember that joke, but imagine that I made that joke. Now you laugh. Taplow, you laughed at my little joke, I noticed. I am pleased at the advance your Latin has made, since you understood the joke, while the rest of the students did not. Perhaps, now, you would be good enough to explain it to them, so that they too can share your pleasure.
The door is pushed open, and Millie Crocker Harris, who is the wife of Crocker Harris, enters. She is more smartly dressed than other schoolmasters' wives. Without noticing who has entered, Mr. Frank said, "Come, Taplow. Don't be selfish. Tell this joke to others." Oh Lord. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Do you think she heard our conversation?
I think she did. She was standing there quite a time. If she had heard, and she tells Mr. Crocker Harris, there goes my remove.
Nonsense. Don't think too much.
Waiting for my husband?
Yes.
He is at the bursar's, and will be there for some time. If I were you, I would go.
He said most particularly that he will come.
Why don't you run a quarter of an hour and come back?
What if he comes here before me?
I will take the blame.
She takes a prescription out of her basket.
I tell you what, you can do a job for him. Take this prescription to the chemist and bring the medicines.
All right, Mrs. Crocker Harris.
Runs to the chemist. The conversation between Taplow and Mr. Frank reveals us the character of Mr. Crocker Harris. He is a disciplinarian and strictly follows the rules of the school. He does no partiality in giving marks to the students. As he said, no less, and certainly no more. On the other hand, the young teacher Frank doesn't follow the rules. He encourages Taplow to talk about Mr. Crocker Harris. He even orders Taplow to repeat the imitation of the master. This is all about this chapter. For more videos, please visit my channel. Goodbye!